Welcome to Motorsport for the running of the DC Solar 250. I'm Paul Fortasers, Luke Rain, to the outside is Jake West. Dan Bammer roll off third, Alex Stewart fourth, and Paul Manick rounds out the top five. So the trucks are on road course here just before the chase starts. This could potentially lock someone into the chase, including Luke Rainey, Jake West, Dan Bam. They need wins to get in unless they get up there in points. Luke Rainey has actually had a really great truck season, just has not gotten that win. He got passed on the last lap a few times, so he's looking for a win here today at a road course just before the chase. 16 laps as the pace truck is in. The field will round the final corner and see the start-finish line get to the restart zone as they come off the final corner. The green flag is in the air. We're racing at Motorsport. Behind them, I think they're wrecking as they're bound for the lead. No caution, but Hunter Bob is gone, of course, along with Evan Rudd. Rudd hits the tires, no yellow. Dan Band and Luke Ray and Jake West are still side by side. Dan Band's in third, just watching these two battling. They are battling out hard. Jake West trying to get that spot from Luke Ray. It looks like he might. No, Luke has the bottom. I think Luke Ray's gonna have it right here. Jake West messed up his corner. And Luke Rainey gets to the race lead, clears as they now fly by under the Bridgestone bridge. It doesn't look like there will be a yellow for Jake West and Hunter Bob going off course, but they have some damage. Behind them now, it might be a battle for second as Luke Rainey has pulled away. Here's a battle back here for fourth, Dan Bannon and Paul Minnick. I think Bannon might get it. Yes, he clears Paul Minnick into the corner. That was close. Now Alex Stewart hunting on Jake West. Looking for a lane as they come off the final corner. Luke Rainey will lead lap number one of today's event. And a huge battle for a second. Jake West and Alex Stewart. Stewart pushing as the caution now has come out for Kevin Bannon off course. And these guys did not take the yellow flag. So they will race it on back now. Looks like a lot of people actually have not taken the yellow. These guys will race it on back to the caution. With Luke Rainey out front, you know, dominating this race. But a restart could change it all. Look at Alex Stewart with a good run on Jake West. Look at West with a run on Luke Rainey. Rainey messed up the corner a little bit, and here comes Jake West. Alex Stewart also messed up his corner just a little bit. But Jake West pressuring Luke Rainey. He's looking. He might have him down in this corner. It's going to be close. They are side by side. Nose. Door handle to door handle. Nose to nose. Jake West trying to clear Luke Rainey. Rainey not going to let him do it. Through the final corner. This is a race to get to the lead for the restart. And it will be Jake West over Luke Rainey. Barely. So they went to the line. Looks like the pace truck will pull out finally. Jake West has taken the yellow. And now let's see what happened to Kevin Bannon, Evan Rudd, Hunter Bob as they all wrecked on that first lap. Here's what happened to Evan Rudd, Hunter Bob. You see, coming over the hill, it looks like I think the O2 Josh Amito and Stuart Grant might have made contact. They went up into Hunter Bob, who hit the wall pretty hard with the rear end of that truck. Stuart Grant gets away. The 10 and the O2 make some contact, and then Evan Rudd coming along, and something happens to that 17. I don't know. Oh, he gets turned by Josh Crash. 17 goes up and hits the tires with the rear end. And then Kevin Bannon and the 7 had some contact at the end of the lap. They actually brought the caution out, as I think he might have slid it up into one of the tires. Oh, no. He and Stuart Grant made contact. Off the corner, it looks like Kevin Bannon drives into Stuart, who then spins out and gets Kevin Bannon in the process. Stuart then spins out. John Gammon also spins. Kevin Bannon, the caution comes out because there are cars or trucks racing by. As Kevin Bannon was sent sideways. Back to the line first was Jake West, who really gained on Luke Rainey that time by. I'm going to say these guys are going to stay out. If they pit, we'll come back. If not, we will take you back to the green flag. We are going back here on lap number 5. Alex Stewart has come down pit road. He only went 2. and he will be 32nd for this restart. Jake West out front, Luke Rainey in second. Third is Dan Bannon, fourth is Paul Mack, and Eric Heiden is in fifth. In sixth, we have John West. In seventh, we have Jeff Zanito. Eighth is Tyler Lyman. Ninth is Derek Bouchard, and rang out the top 10 is Eli Bright. 11th is Brandon Butler. 12th is Griffin Lynn. 13th is Dale Petty. 14th is left Eric Ducole. And 15th, we have Christian Merrick Jr. And 16th is Trey Rainey. 17th is Josh Amito. 18th is Cynthia Bright. 19th is Jacob Morgan. And 20th is Levi Shones. 21st is Junior Ellis. 22nd, Jeff Bright. 23rd is Jim Gamet. 24th, Josh Crash. Riley Sperling, 25th. 26th, Brandon Belder, Senior Points Leader. 27th, Hunter Bow. 28th, John Gamet. 29th, Stuart Gratton. 30th, Evan Red. 31st, Kevin Bann. And here comes Alex Stewart trying to catch up to the field in time in 30 seconds. The pace truck is in. Off of the final court. Green flag back in the air for Jake West, who takes off. And now Luke Gray's going to have to hold off Dan Bann, who makes a move going into turn one. Dan Bann with a good restart. Luke Rainey trying to hold second place. So they race up the hill. Oh, contact! Justin Mito around! On the restart, big wreck! Eli Bright, Derek Bouchard, Dale Petty goes sliding. Justin Mito, Tyler Lyman with damage. There's a truck upside down. It's Dale Petty who got hit hard by possibly Hunter Bob. The caution will come out. Once again here at Motorsport, a wreck on the restart. Jake West trying to lead Luke Rainey back. Behind them, Dan Bannon, Paul Minnick. Minnick will get the third position. Luke Rainey has closed in on Jake West now. Can he do what West did to him? Coming back to the caution flag and get to the race lead. Doesn't look like he's close enough to do it yet. He would really have to drive it into this corner. I think it's a little too early to dive it in for the lead. But we might see something like that later in this race as they go through the final corners to take the caution flag. Jake West and Luke Rainey are nose to tail. It looks like it will be Jake West as Luke Rainey kind of went wide in one of those final corners. And Jake West leads us back to the yellows. A big wreck just after the restart involving Justin Mito and others. Let's see what happens. Here they are on the restart. You see Tyler Lyman and Jeff Semedo battling. It looks like Semedo and Lyman make contact. I think Tyler went up into the 24. Jeff hits the wall hard. He comes up into Derek Bouchard's nowhere to go. Eli Bright gets a ton of damage in that 31 truck. It looks like Brandon Butler got damaged. They go off course. Dale Petty gets spun out by, it looks like, Christian Merrick Jr. And then the 5's going to get hit really hard and go upside down. Oh! Looks like Brad Butler Sr. got spun by Hunter Bomb. Bob nowhere to go, nails the 5 and flips him over. The 5 truck then comes back on its wheels. But what a tough break for these guys. Let's look at this in real time. This is a wild wreck. See, the wreck happens up ahead. They're hitting hard. They slide off the track. And then Brad Butler Sr. gets nailed by the 94, possibly trying to check up. And the 94 possibly did not have any brakes. Is that it looks like he just went full power into the 5 without stopping. So that brings down another caution, and Jacobs have to deal with another restart here in that 29 truck. He lets back to the yellow. He's out front. He'll take us back to the restart with under 10 laps to go. We'll go back here in just before halfway on lap number 8, and there are now trucks out of this race. Dale Petty after flipping, Hunter Bob after flipping the 5, and Justin Mito, who was one of them that started the wreck. So we have 29 cars left in this race, with the race leader being Jake West. In second, we have Luke Rainey. Third is Paul Mack. Fourth, Dan Bann. And fifth is Eric Heiden. In sixth, we have John West. Seventh is left Eric Ducole. Eighth is Griffin Lynn. Ninth is Brandon Butler. And tenth, we have Tyler Lyman. 11th is Cynthia Bright. 12th is Christian Merrick Jr. 13th is Levi Shelms. 14th, Junior Ellis. 15th is Jim Gamet. 16th, Jacob Morgan. 17th is Jeff Bright. 18th is Josh Mito. 19th is Josh Crash, and 20th is Stuart Grant. 21st is Riley Sperling, 22nd Kevin Bann, 23rd is John Gamet, 24th is Evan Rudd, 25th is Trey Rainey, 26th Alex Stewart, 27th is Brandon Butler Sr., 28th Derek Bouchard, and 29th, running out the field, is Eli Bright, who came down pit road. So here we go, pace truck in, another restart here at Motorsport. Let's come off the final corner, down the front stretch, the green flag is in the air. West with a great start there, gets away from Luke Rainey. Now Paul Mack looks low. Just like what Dan Bann did to Rainey last time, except it did not work for Dan Bann. This time it might work for Paul Minnick, as Rainey will get cleared by the 62. Now does Luke Gray have a run for Paul Mac, or do these guys work together and try and catch Jake West? They come up a hill. Past the Continental Tire Bridge. This is the corner where I think you can get to Jake West. See back there, whoa, Dan Bannon loose! He's gonna get underneath Luke Gray and passed. And Bannon might get to second right here. He's going by Paul Minnick. What a run for Dan Bannon there. What a corner for him. He's going to get 2-for-1 possibly. Just has to hold that position inside of Paul Minnick. And we will see halfway this time by with Jake West out front. Dan Bannon's battling for second with Paul Minnick. This way behind Jake West. Though. It's in fact slowing them down. Dan Bannon will get by Paul Minnick. Now he's going to have his sights set on Jake West. Halfway as they come off the final corner. And Jake West is leading here at Mosport. Dan Bannon, Paul Minnick going to try and catch there right now. Second and third. Luke Gray has fallen back to fourth after a series of unfortunate events for him. On restarts, it looks like he might have spun his tires. And both times, trucks got to the inside of him. Dan Bannon the first time, and then this last time, which was the most cost-effective, was Paul Minnick, who right now settles into third. Right now, no real battles. It's just these guys minding their P's and Q's right now. After seeing what has happened the past few restarts with these wrecks, they want to kind of calm it down a little bit here and try and race it to the end. So this is the corner I think you can really get on Jake West, especially if you're Dan Bannon. He's just had such a great time with this corner. Looks like he gains just a little bit there. West, yeah, I think West might have lost just a little bit right there, but I don't know if it's enough. Paul Mack and Luke Rainey pretty close. Rainey, I thought, close in just a little bit more, but now might be a battle for fourth. Luke Rainey and Eric Heiner closer than anyone has been. As Jake West get around the final few corners and see 7 laps to go at Mosport. Comes off the final corner. Jake West still leading with 7 laps to go in the DC Solar 250. Dan Bannon trying to run him down. Bannon, last lap, ran his fast lap of the race, and it was 3/10 faster than Jake West. We will keep the interval up for you, trying on 1.2 seconds. And Luke Rainey is actually pulled away from Eric Heiner. The battle for fifth is going to be on as 3 trucks are within range. John West and left air Stu Cole battling right now for sixth. 60 truck on the back bumper of the 19. Ooh, look at the run for the 60 there. Good core there. Watch Dan Bannon here through these next few corners. This is really where he's able to make up his time. Right here, this section of the track is where he makes up all of his time on the 29 truck. Paul Mack and Luke Rainey. Rainey got a good run on him for third if they start battling. And Dan Bannon, I think, actually lost ground to the 29 truck that time. But Luke Rainey is basically pushing Paul Mack. Rainey with a nose? No, not quite yet. He's on the back bumper of that 62, though. My gosh. He might wreck him to get by him. And Eric Heiner watching this from fifth. You know, this battle for third between 3 trucks, as I think the gap will increase this time with 6 laps to go. It has raised drastically. It's up 0.5 seconds from the last time by, so Jake West right now out front of that clean air, and it's really showing for him. See, he's dominating and pulling away from the rest of the field. And right now we're looking at these battles for third and second and fourth. As Jake West is all by himself out front. Dan Bannon not really able to do anything with him. So you have to tiptoe it through these corners. Right now the top 5 actually pulled away. Then John West, look at this battle. Brandon Butler and Griffin Lynn in a little bit of a battle. Butler couldn't do anything back there. They're side by side. Looks like Jim Gambit and Jeff Breyer side by side for the 14th position. Jeff Breyer might have it down here in this corner. Looks like Bright trying to clear Jim Gambit, and he will. So Jeff Bright, moving him up a spot to 14th. We just saw that pass being made. John West catches Eric Heiner here, trying to move himself into the top 5 to get with his teammate, but it looks like Dan Bannon has caught Jake West. It must have happened in that corner that we were talking about where Jeff Bright made the pass. That corner really helps some people gain positions. Because you probably make way out wide. If Luke Rainey was there, that 88 trick would have gotten right up by the 62. But look at Dan Bann, how close he is now to the 29 truck with now 5 laps to go. The gap is down to 0.4 seconds. He is coming. Does he have enough time? Can he get by the 29 truck, or does he fall off again? Like the last time he gained time, he actually lost it. Battle for fourth is still 3 trucks with the 88 leading this train around. They're trying to catch Paul Manning for a third. And then in front, Dan Bann trying to stalk and run down Jake West. He has run him down. Can he pass him now? Come to 4 to go this time. Here's this corner again. Does Dan Bann close any more than he did last time? Oh, he went a little wide there. And Jake West will pull away just a little bit. And that's exactly what probably Jake West did the lap prior. Dan Bann does it this time, pushing hard. The battle behind is for fourth. Eric Heiden and Luke Rainey are side by side. Move Heiden to fourth. Rainey back to fifth. Luke Rainey on the downfall from starting on the pole. He led the first lap. Ever since then, it's been Jake West out front, and he's been falling. Yeah, you can see now Jake West has actually opened it up, coming to 4 laps to go on Dan Bandon. It's probably up to a second now. Maybe even more than that. Jake West, 4 laps to go at Motorsport. The gap now is up to a second. But if Dan Bann gets another corner like he did 2 laps ago through that one corner, he will catch the 29 truck. Because remember, that last time by, he was 1.7 seconds back, and he closed it down to 0.4 in a lap. If he has another corner like that and Jake West messes up again, watch out for Dan Bann to maybe possibly make a pass. Your points leader right now in the 81. Not running so hot with damage back in 27th position. As Josh crashed out because of a piston, I don't think he was at before. Look at Dan Bann has closed in on Jake West. West goes wide. Here comes Dan Bann with the run. Watch out. Bandon looking on Jake West. He's side by side. Dan Bann and Jake West into this corner. Side by side, door handle to door handle. Bandon with a run, has the inside. He clears Jake West, move Dan Bann to P1. Here at Motorsport, coming to 3 laps to go. Jake West has led most of this race. He has led all but 1 lap. And now coming down to 3 laps to go, he'll lose the lead to Dan Bandon with 3 laps to go. Bandon, your new race leader, by 0.4. The battle might be for third now. Paul Manning and Eric Heiden. Heiden is closing in here lately. Last time by was 0.5 seconds faster than that 62. Dan Bandon was almost 2 seconds faster than Jake West. And Bandon just cannot mess up these corners. These really slow corners, just take it nice and easy if you're the race leader. See, Jake West is staying with Dan Bandon. Obviously, West just made a little mistake. And if Dan Bandon makes that same mistake, or even if Bandon doesn't even make a mistake, West has showed he has the dominant truck. Bandon, now in the position where Jake West was last time by, where West made a mistake. Bandon makes the mistake. West doesn't capitalize, though. West made that same mistake coming to 2 laps to go this time. He will not be in a position to pass. And the front four are gone. Luke Rainey is fifth on back. Fifth to a back to about ninth, tenth are in this pack. Coming to 2 laps to go, Dan Bann just has to keep it out front and he will lock himself into the chase. He's been up there in points all season long. He just has not gotten a win to show that he can make the chase. And this could be the day. Coming to 2 laps to go where he gets that win to make the chase. And so they come down the front stretch. Dan Bann and Jake West come behind the billboard. 2 laps to go at Motorsport, the DC Solar 250. Coming to the end. If I'm Dan Bann, I'm telling myself, just do not mess up that one corner down here. Jake West did the mistake last lap and 2 laps ago. Dan Bann did the mistake last lap. However, West doing the mistake also kept Dan Bann up front. As right now, the front four within 2 seconds, and then fifth place is 4.5 back. So obviously, showing how this gap is. And Paul Manic has actually caught these two. If these two make the same mistake last time as they did last time, watch Paul Manic. Here they are in this corner. Watch Jake West in second. Watch Dan Bannon with the race lead. Bannon wide and Jake West has a run. Here comes Jake West with Dan Bannon. Side by side. Dan Bannon with a great launch off the corner. Keeps it. Coming to the white flag this time. Jake West, Dan Bannon, and Paul Minnick are all right there. West blocks Minnick. Here they are. Three trucks have a shot to win at Most Sport. White flag this time. Jake West, Paul Minnick, Dan Bannon. Minnick pushing West, West pushing Bannon. They will end the race under the green flag as they come off the final corner. White flag for Dan Bannon one more time around Most Sport. I don't believe they will catch any lap traffic. Minnick makes a move underneath West. He has it. He has cleared Jake West. Can Paul Minnick make a move on Dan Bannon? Bannon has made a mistake in that one area the past two laps. If he does it again, Minnick will be there and pass. Minnick looking there. That 62 truck has found something. There he saved something. He's on rails right now, trying to catch Dan Bannon. We will not need the leaderboard for any more of this race as we're on the final lap. Watch this corner. If Bannon makes a mistake, Minnick will close to the inside. Bannon, Minnick make the same mistake. However, West cannot make a move on Minnick just yet. Dan Bannon right now has this unless something happens in these final few corners. Here they are. They will see the final few corners. Minnick trying to make a move. He has the draft of Dan Bannon. Can that do anything for him? As here they come into the final few corners. Bannon and Minnick. Nose to tail. Minnick on the back bumper. Bannon. If that 68 goes wide, watch the 62. Final few corners. No one can do anything with Dan Bannon. Around the final corner, Dan Bannon will lock himself into the chase with the win in the Most Sport. Four trucks finishing. Here comes Luke Rainey for fifth. John West looks like he'll end up sixth, but Dan Bannon with a late lace pass holds off Paul Manic and Jake West to win the DC Solar 250 at Most Sport and lock himself into the Pennzoil Truck Series chase where he will have a shot to win the championship. Let's check the finishing results. Here are the finishing results from the DC Solar 250 at Most Sport. There were three caution flags for four laps and only two lead changes among three different drivers, and Dan Bannon won the race after leading the final four laps with a late lap pass over Jake West, who finishes third. But Paul Manic ends up second. Jake West, who led the most laps, ends up third. Fourth, Eric Hine, the guy that started on pole, Luke Rainey, led the first lap, ends up fifth. He is now your points leader, and that is significant. We will tell you why in just a second. John West is sixth, seventh, Tyler Lyman, eighth, Junior Ramos, ninth, Jeff Bright, and in tenth, Cynthia Bright. So there's your top 20. And now this is go time, man. Go time. We only have a few races before the chase. It's going to get exciting. Down these guys involved in wrecks and not the days they were wanting. In fact, I believe like 24th on back actually had damage from that one big incident. All right, now let's go to the point standings. Here are the point standings after 13 races, and with four races to go before the chase, Luke Rainey is on top of the points lead by 18 points over Junior Ramos in second. Brandon Butler Sr. is third, fourth Dan Bannon with that win, and Eric Hines fifth. John Gamma is sixth, Cynthia Bright seventh, eighth is Trey Rainey, 9th Jeff Bright, and 10th Alex Stewart. So this is your top 20. You can see only eight drivers are within a race of Luke Rainey coming into the final four race before the chase. You can see right now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 winners in the top 20. Now, as we look down at the rest, you have 8, 9, 10. However, since Luke Rainey is in the points lead without a win, Hunter Bob would not get that chase spot, and Luke Rainey would, because the points lead overrules a win. And now guys down here, Eli Bright and Jacob Morgan, they are close to the top 25 in points, so they have to get there, win another race, and get up there. So it's going to be interesting. But right now, Luke Rainey has the final transfer spot because of his points situation. He either has to keep that or win. And we have another road course next. And that road course is Old Spice Speedway for the Old Spice 200. See you guys then.